Hello and good afternoon to all. Am I audible to you? Am I audible to you clearly?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So we will start our today's session. Okay, you know that today is the online session because of this work from home activity. Okay, hope that all you are safe and fine. Okay, so we will start our today's session. That is operating system and administration. Now, dear student, what we see in the last offline class, that is unit number 2, we were about to start the kernel data structure for process control subsystem, isn't it? Okay, that was our topic, process control subsystem for kernel data structure for process control subsystem. Okay, so what I will do, I will just start the PPT. Okay, I will load the PPT, share the PPT with you. Just a minute. Okay, so here it is. I started the PPT. You can the PPT is visible to all of you. Is the screen visible? Is the screen visible to you? So, dear students, see, in the last lecture, offline class, we have seen or we already started the process control subsystem. So, what is the process? You know, a process is the execution of the program. Rather, I said that time as process is the instance of the program which is in execution. And what the process consists? Process consists of object code that is called as program to be executed. Process consists of data which the process can work on, and also the process contain the stack, and process contain the required resources. So this is the figure where you can come to know all the points, or we can call it as the instances. What do you mean by instance? So that resource is the one instance of the process. Code is the another instance of the process. Data is the another instance of the process. Status is the another instance of the process. So altogether we can say that the process is the program which is in execution, or the instance of the program which is in execution. So that is there. Okay, now next is many process can run simultaneously. Okay, as kernel schedules them for execution, many process can run simultaneously. Like there are P1, P2, P3, P4, all these process can run simultaneously, and kernel schedules them for execution. So what is the scheduling? That means the kernel can schedule them for execution so that CPU can execute the process. Now next line tells us that the several process may be an instance of one program. Okay, that already we explained. A process reads and writes its data and stack section, but it cannot read and write the data or the stack section of other process. So normally there are three sections, that is the text section, data section, and the stack section. The one process can read and write the text, data, and the stack section of its own, but it cannot read and write the text, data, and stack section of other process. Okay, and obviously that the process can communicate with all process in the Unix system are created by a fork system called except the very first process, that is a process zero, which is created by the system at the time of booting. Now there is a exec system call which is used by kernel to load the executable file into the memory, and then there is a loaded process is having text, data, and stack section, and stack consists of the logical stack frames. And this stack is automatically created, and its size is dynamically changed whenever the push and the pop operation will take place. So, what will be the push and what will pop from the stack? Okay, what will push and what will pop from the stack? So, logical stack frames will be pushed onto the stack, and these logical stack frames will be pop from the stack. So when it will be pushed, so whenever the function will be called, then it will be pushed, and whenever function will be executed or it will return some value, then the logical stack frame will pop. And what is this logical stack frame? This logical stack frame, it contains the logical local variables. Okay, as last line you can read there, it contains the local variables, address of the previous frame, return address, and parameter to the functions. Okay, all these things are nothing but the content of that logical stack frame. Okay, now the next figure can give you the idea that what actually the stack. So this sample program or the program which normally used to copy the location of one program to other location. Okay, copy a program, so we called it as a copy command. So here with the when this program is loaded into the memory. Okay, how it can be loaded? Who can tell how this program can be loaded into the memory by a kernel? Okay, how this program can be loaded into the memory by kernel? This is a program. Now suppose the user create this program. Now we want to execute the program. So what will be the internal operation take place? Okay, how this program is loaded into basically, this program is first of all available on the secondary storage device, that is your hard disk. Okay, and now you want to load. you want to execute that program, so what operation will take place? Or directly I can ask, the what system call can be used to load that program into the memory? What system call can be used to load that program into the memory? EXEC. Yes, Jaydeep Nikam and Shraddha, both are these students are giving the correct answer. Dipti is also giving the correct answer. EXEC system call. Yes, means now this is important to know that what is the EXEC. EXEC is the system call that is used to load the program into the memory. Okay, so that who will schedule the program for execution? Once the program is loaded, now this student have given the answer that EXEC system call will be used to load that program into the memory. That is correct. Absolutely right. Now, once the program is loaded into the memory, who will schedule that program for execution? Who will schedule that program for execution? Who will schedule that program for execution? Kernel. Correct. Absolutely right. Kernel will schedule that program for execution. Now, next question is, who will execute that program? After scheduling, after kernel schedule the program for execution, CPU, correct, very good. Dipti has given the correct answer. CPU will execute the program. So, means what I am trying to understand that you people are now getting the what is the sequence of the operation, what is the sequence of the execution, how this process will be loaded, how this program will be loaded into the memory. It will be loaded by the memory by using EXEC system call. And then kernel schedule that program for execution, and CPU then execute that program. So yesterday in the classroom, I told you that there are scheduling algorithms, like there is a priority based scheduling, round robin based scheduling. Then there is a shortage job first, first come first serve. So according to this scheduling algorithm, kernel then pick up the process for execution. Okay. So this is a standard algorithm, and in higher classes, you will come to know that how this actual execution will take place by this algorithms, scheduling algorithms. Okay, but this is again a widely used. So scheduling, no, and that means you can schedule your process by CPU. Okay, so यहाँ तक अभी हम आ चुके हैं कि like kernel can make the use of the EXEC system call to load the program into the memory. Okay, and then kernel will schedule that process for execution. And CPU will execute that process. Now suppose now CPU ne execution chalu kiya, then very first the program will start from hash include this fcnl.h, okay, and then variables are there, declaration of variables. Now main comes, main function comes, then there is a declaration of variables, characters, and then you can see there is a successive functions like exit, open. Then there is again this create, copy, exit. So all these functions are there, and whenever the program is executing by the kernel, sorry, by the CPU, then one by one this function will be called, or we can say that the functions will be under executing. So then what happened, that you will see by this figure, that is called as the user stack and the kernel stack. So we know that this stack will be created automatically. The stack were not there initially. Okay, stack will created automatically. So agar ye stack automatically create ho chuka hai, then its size will dynamically change. So initially the stack will be empty. Okay, the stack is empty. Initially the stack is empty. And now its size will dynamically change. So we know the process how it will change. It will change by adding the logical stack frame. Okay, so you can add and you can remove also. You can push and you can pop. You means the kernel can do this. Kernel will do this. Okay, so in user stack, what happens? Normally you can see the local variable, then frame, logical frame, and the return address along with the parameters. This will be added. So same thing will be added. Now here you can see in the user stack there are three functions. No, so one is in this blue color. Then this is in red color, this is in a green color. So three functions were there, and you can see each function is having a variables. Now what is the variable? Locally variable. So f old and f new is the locally variable. Now add of, that is the address of this frame 0. Add means this is the address. Oh? This is the address, not addition. This is the address of frame 0 and the return address after main call. Okay. So parameter to this main are argument C and argument V. So this is the first logical frame that will be added. So rather I can use the word that will be push. That will be pushed on the user stack whenever the main function will call. यहाँ तक समझ में आ रहा है सबको? CPU तक आप आ चुके थे. CPU is now executing the process. So once the process is under execution, now the stack will be created automatically. Stack will be created automatically. So very first function is the main function. So now the logical stack frame will be created. Here you can see on the right hand side at the bottom, call main, frame 0 start, call main, that is frame 1. Okay, and this frame 1 will contain main and its arguments, return address after main call, address of frame 0, and local variables like f old and f new. Now frame 2. Now frame 2, that means another function, no? Copy function. Copy function. So now what is this? A copy function. So copy function is again having a parameter to copy like old and new. Return address after copy call. Address of frame 1. And local variable count. Got it? That is a frame 2. And now frame 3, you can see what is frame 3. It contains the write function. Write. So it contains a parameter to write, a new buffer and count, return address after write call, address of the frame 2 and local variable like not sure, that there is no local variable in this write. So that is a user stack. Everybody got this? Okay. So stack is automatically created and its size is dynamically changed whenever the function will be called and function will be written. Sorry. So whenever I call the function, the logical stack will be push, and whenever I return the function, then I mean whenever the function itself returns something, then it will be pop. Everybody clear with this thing? Because our topic name is internal representation of Unix system, no? Design and implementation of the Unix operating system. That is the title of our book. So this is very important, na? Ki ye process execute hoti hai, to matlab kya hota hai? Ye aapko samajh mein aana chahiye, and this is a very good platform to understand these things. So kahan se chalu kiya tha humne? We started with the process. Process is the instance of the program which is in execution, and one process can have different instances. Okay. Once the process is ready for execution, so kernel loads that process into the memory by using exec system call. CPU is ready for execution with the help of a CPU scheduling algorithm. So here you can mention that any one of these algorithm can be choose, shortage job first, round robin, priority, or the first come first serve. And now once the process is under execution, then a stack frame will be push onto the stack. Before that, you can use the sentence like a stack will be created, or you can use the sentence like each process is having three types of sections, regions, the text region, data region, and the stack region, where the stack region contains the logical stack frames, and it will be automatically created and dynamically changed whenever the function will be called and function will be written. Okay, push and pop, इसका भी use आप कर सकते हैं। तो ये very easy to understand, but you need to remember this process. Okay, यहाँ तक कोई problem है? Is there any problem till this topic, or you want something more? So now what I will do, I will move back. This is your process, actual program. Kernel loads the executable file into the memory with exec system call. Loaded process consists of the text, data, and stack section. And stack consists of the logical stack frames, where the stack frames are nothing but it contains the local variables, address of the previous frame, return address, and parameter to the function. Okay, and then next we can move. So a kernel has a process table that keeps the track of all active processes. Okay, now a process table is there, that is very important entity of this operating system. Process table is there, process table. So like we already learned, no, that is there is a file descriptor table, file table, inode table. Okay, that all things were related to the file subsystem, but now the process control subsystem is having the process table. So the process table that keep the track of all active processes. So this sentence you keep in mind that a kernel has a process table, and what it contains, it keep the track of all active process. Active process means which are under execution, which are already scheduled, and they are executing by the kernel. That all that process are now available in the process table. Now what it contains, the per process region table, my dear student. Okay, you read the sentence once again. A process table contain the per process region table. Okay, प्रोसेस टेबल में क्या रहेगा? प्रोसेस टेबल में पर प्रोसेस रीजन टेबल रहेगा. पर प्रोसेस, हर एक प्रोसेस के लिए एक पर प्रोसेस रीजन टेबल रहेगा. यू कैन इमेजिन द पिक्चर ना. सो द प्रोसेस टेबल इज देयर, एंड देन इट कंटेन्स द एक्टिव प्रोसेसेस P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, एंड द P1 प्रोसेस, फॉर P1 प्रोसेस इट इज हैविंग अ पर प्रोसेस रीजन टेबल. पर प्रोसेस रीजन टेबल, एंड दैट रीजन टेबल, पर प्रोसेस रीजन टेबल हुज एंट्री पॉइंट्स टू एंट्रीज इन द रीजन टेबल. नाउ रीजन टेबल इज डिफरेंट. पर प्रोसेस रीजन टेबल एंड देयर इज इट पॉइंट्स टुवर्ड द एंट्रीज इन द रीजन टेबल. ओके, तो कितने टेबल हो गए अभी? थ्री टेबल्स. नो, प्रोसेस टेबल व्हिच कंटेन्स द ऑल एक्टिव प्रोसेसेस, देन पर प्रोसेस रीजन टेबल. ओके, वो हर एक प्रोसेस के लिए अलग अलग रहेगा, एंड दैट पर प्रोसेस रीजन टेबल विल पॉइंट टूवर्ड द एंट्रीज इन द रीजन टेबल. सो देर आर थ्री रीजन्स. नो, देर आर थ्री रीजन्स. व्हाट आर दैट रीजन्स? व्हाट आर दैट रीजन्स? व्हाट आर द थ्री रीजन्स? टेक्स्ट, डेटा एंड स्टैक. करेक्ट, एब्सोल्युटली राइट. सो देर आर थ्री रीजन्स, टेक्स्ट रीजन, डेटा रीजन एंड द स्टैक रीजन. सो दैट पर प्रोसेस रीजन टेबल हुज एंट्रीज पॉइंट्स टू एंट्रीज इन द रीजन टेबल. सो थ्री रीजन टेबल्स देर आर, द टेक्स्ट रीजन, डेटा रीजन एंड द स्टैक रीजन. सो नाउ वी विल मूव द स्लाइड एंड वी विल कम टू नो द एग्जैक्ट दिस डेटा स्ट्रक्चर फॉर द प्रोसेस. सो what is this process table? You can see the process table is there with the green color. Okay, and here now the process table, what it contains? It contains the all active processes P1, P2, P3, and then har ek process ke liye per process region table hai, per process region table, and then entry in the per process region table will points toward the entry in the region table. So actually, how many regions are there? So text, data, and the stack regions. And then the entries in the region table will point to the main memory, that is the RAM, where the actual process will be executing. How it can be executing? With the help of variables, with the help of registers, with the help of data, with the help of instructions, with the help of values, variables, functions, and many more things are there that actually running in the main memory. तो प्रोसेस को क्या चाहिए? प्रोसेस एग्जीक्यूशन करने के लिए मेन मेमोरी की जरूरत है, एंड ऑल दिस थिंग्स आर हैपनिंग इन द मेन मेमोरी. ओके, And you can ask, what is this U area? So that is the user area, no? User area. So what is the user area? So user area is the user area where user can write his own program with the help of text, data, and stack. Okay. So stack basically is not there in existence, but the text and data is there. So user can play with this text and data in the user area, and then the important part comes when the function is called. And without function, it's hardly impossible to execute any program or any process. So even though you are not writing any function, the main will be there, the system call will be there. Printf is a function, no? Scanf is a function. So all these things are nothing but a function which will be executed, and once it will be executed, the stack will be created, stack will be created, the stack frames will be created, stack frames will be pushed, stack frames will be popped, and this will be continued. This is the actual process of the execution that will be take place by process control subsystem. Yahan tak samajh mein aa raha hai sabko? Okay, and the heading, you can see the data structure for the process. So here I can add one word, kernel data structure for process. So that is a part of today's discussion, kernel data structure for process. So you just remember this figure and you will come to know what is the data structure for the process. Okay, that is very important. This figure and that figure for file table, then the inode table, the file descriptor table, that all things all together, that how many data structures are there? Can anybody tell me how many data structures are there for kernel? Abhi aapne dekha hai, how many data structures are there for kernel? So kernel data structure, can anybody list out there the kernel data structure all together? Kernel data structure all together. Kernel data structure, how many data structures are there? What are the data structure of the kernel? Yes. Abhay, you are there. Abhay Lahare is there. Can you unmute your audio for a few minutes, few seconds, and can you tell us what are the kernel data structure? Abhay, Abhishek, Ajay, anybody from these three can unmute their audio. Akash, two Akash also there. Akash Karpe and Akash Nikali. Okay. Anybody can unmute and give me the answer that what are the kernel data structures available? Kernel data structure. The first three and second two, these five students are not able to respond. Okay, Akshay, can you able to reply? Six. He is saying that six data structures are there. And Siddhant is saying that there is a process table, per process region table, region table, file table, inode table, file descriptor table. Well, RA is now active. Okay, he is active in the passive state. Yes or no? Huh? You are not able to respond when I said that you unmute your audio and speak something. That time you are not able to speak. You can write an inode table and file table. Jaydev is saying that there are four. Four, how you can say four? Okay, what are the four? Okay, Jaydev, you are saying that four are there. Darshan is saying that the file directory table. File directory, my dear student, what is this file directory table? Okay, it is not a file directory, this is a file, this is the descriptor table, no? File descriptor table. File table, inode table. That is related to file subsystem, and process control subsystem is having this process table, per process region table, region table. Okay, all these are the data structure for the kernel. Okay, so jo kuch hum pad rahe file subsystem ke bare mein, like there is a inode table, file table, then the file descriptor table. Okay, And you can add one more there. That is, inode itself is having various entities, no? So inode table तक आप आ चुके हैं. So like you are saying that the inode table is there, no? So उसके आगे comma करके आप inode को भी ले सकते हैं. Inode is a data structure. So inode contains many more fields. It contains the user ID, group ID, time of creation, time of access, directories, links, single indirect, double indirect, okay? Then the signature, then it contains the link, it contains the protection mode, it contains the size of the file, it contains the owner of the file, group owner of the file. So inode itself also a data structure, okay? So file subsystem ke bare mein agar aapko question aaya, okay? फाइल सब सिस्टम के बारे में अगर आपको किसी ने पूछा कि व्हाट आर द कर्नल डेटा स्ट्रक्चर रिलेटेड टू द फाइल सब सिस्टम, देन यू कैन आंसर दैट देयर इज द आईनोड इज द फर्स्ट डेटा स्ट्रक्चर, आईनोड टेबल इज द सेकंड डेटा स्ट्रक्चर, फाइल टेबल इज द थर्ड डेटा स्ट्रक्चर, एंड फाइल डिस्क्रिप्टर टेबल इज द फोर्थ डेटा स्ट्रक्चर फॉर फाइल सब सिस्टम. और अगर आपको किसी ने पूछा कि व्हाट आर द कर्नल डेटा स्ट्रक्चर रिलेटेड टू द प्रोसेस सबसिस्टम, देन यू कैन रिप्लाई, सो देयर इज अ प्रोसेस टेबल, देयर इज अ पर प्रोसेस रीजन टेबल, देयर इज अ रीजन टेबल, और इसके आगे आप देख सकते हैं देयर इज अ प्रोसेस इटसेल्फ, नो प्रोसेस पीआईडी, वी कॉल इट एज अ प्रोसेस आईडी, ओके, ईच प्रोसेस इज हैविंग अ प्रोसेस आईडी. So that can also be a process. So instead of calling a process ID, you can call process itself. Okay, that is a process table, per process region table, and the region table are the data structure of the kernel related to the process control subsystem. So this thing is clear to everybody. Okay, now we move forward. What is a process table? So process table, you can now see the field of the process table entry. So what it contains? Process table, it contains the state field, okay? State field. Second, it contains the user ID, owner of the process, and it contains the event descriptor set when the process is suspended. So these things are there with respect to process table. So what is the process table? Process table containing the all active processes, and all active processes are having a state field, the state of the process. Okay, so later on I will explain you what are the state of the process. State is the behavior of the process. So process is under waiting state, process is under suspension state, process is under execution state, process is under ready to run state. So many states are there. So there is a state field in the process table. There is a state field that can give you the idea that under which state the process is currently functioning. Okay, so what it contains? It contains the first field, that is the process state field. State process table contains the state field, and then the second is it contains the UID of the process. User ID, who is the user who is executing that process, so that is nothing but the UID, owner of the process. And then lastly, it contains the event descriptor. It actually the set, event descriptor set, when a process is suspended. Okay, now you can suspend the process. Kernel can suspend the process. So what do you mean by suspension? Suspension means the process execution can be halted. It can be suspended for a time. A process can be going for halt, you know, halt. So it is not functioning, its execution is suspended. So whenever the process is under suspension, then whatever the actual context of the process, okay, I use the word context, process kya kar rahi hai, okay, what are the events, what is the functioning, or what are the operations, process are executing by that process before the suspension, that is nothing but the event descriptor. समझ में आ रहा है आपको? समझ में आ रहा है क्या? what is mean by event descriptor? So process can go for suspension. Can go means the kernel can suspend the process. Kernel can suspend the process, and there are many reasons. Okay, later on we will see what are the reasons for that the process can suspend. Suppose you want to suspend the child process and you want to execute the parent process. So that means the child goes under suspension. तो उसका एग्जीक्यूशन आपने स्टॉप किया है. तो अगर उसका एग्जीक्यूशन आपने स्टॉप किया है तो बिफोर सस्पेंशन वो प्रोसेस कुछ ना कुछ काम तो कर रही थी ना. तो काम कर रही थी मतलब वो काम आपको सेव करके रखना पड़ेगा. तो कॉन्टेक्स्ट उसे क्या कहते हैं, द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ द प्रोसेस दैट यू नीड टू सेव. जैसे कि आपको मैं एग्जाम्पल देता हूँ कि अभी आप हमारा गूगल मीट चल रहा है. राइट नाउ वी आर इंटरेक्टिंग विद ईच अदर विद गूगल मीट. Okay, now suppose for example this Akshay is the one process. So Akshay is the one process, and that process is doing, he is currently active. That means Akshay is doing many functions, many operations currently are going on at the Akshay side. And suddenly, if I suspend that process, if I suspend that process, that means whatever the activities currently the Akshay is doing, that will be saved. उसे क्या कहते हैं? Context of the Akshay. Context of the Akshay will be saved. So you can ask the question, sir, why to need to save the context? क्या जरूरत है उसकी? क्यों save करना है? It is required. It is required to save the context of the process so that after some time or later on the process is again resumed. Okay, at any point of time the process can again resume its function. So that time the kernel should know what is the context of that process before resume or before suspension. So wo wahan se hi chalu karega na. So what the kernel will come to know that yes, this is the register A, this is register B, this is the register C, this is the content of program counter, this is the content of stack register, this is the content of debug register, test registers. Many registers are there, na? You learn in the computer organization register set. Okay, so that is called as the event descriptor. So the set, it is a set, as I said, that it is a set, event descriptor set when the process is suspended. So my dear students, so there are many things to learn and understand related to the process table. It contains the state field. So what is the state? State is the behavior of the process. So it can be under ready state, it can be under waiting state, it can be under suspension state, it can be under execution state. So there are many states. If baad mein aapko state diagram mein dikhaunga, so what are the state of the process? So that is the one field of the process table. Second field is the user ID, that is the UID, owner of the process. And last one is the event descriptor. It actually contains the set of the event descriptor, and that is required when the time of process suspension. Okay, yaad to samajh mein aaya sabko? Sorry. And then the next you can see there is a pointer to the U pointer, that is the address to the user. So figure mein aap dekh sakte hain there is a pointer. So process table containing the pointer. So this is the pointer actually. U area is there, that is the user area, and process table is containing the U pointer, so user pointer. The user is pointing towards any one of the state of the process, or it can be pointing towards the UID of the process, or it can be pointing towards the event descriptor state. So it can be means what happened, actually the user is pointing towards process table. Okay, that means this UID is there. Now you come to know that who is the owner of the process, that only can come to know by this U pointer, that is the address of the user. Okay, so if this pointer is not there, then this UID is of difficult to understand, difficult to recognize that who is the user, who is the user who currently related to that process. समझ में आ रहा है क्या बच्चों? Are you getting what we are learning here? So now next we move toward the next, that is a process region table. Now region is a continuous area of the process. Contiguous area of the process, address space such as text, data and stack. Okay, a region, three types of regions are there. A region is what? It is a continuous process area. It is a contiguous area of the process address space. Okay, it's the area of the process address space, and the three regions are there, the text, data and stack. The region table entry describes the attributes of the region, such as whether it contains the text or data, whether it is shared or private, and where the data of the region is located in the memory. So you can see what the region table entry describes. The region table normally contains the text, data and the stack, and each that text region, data region and the stack region is describing the attributes of where it contains the text or data, whether it's shared or private, or where the data of the region is located in the memory. So this thing will be pointed by each region. Okay, three regions are there: text region, data region and stack region. And this region table entries describe the attributes of the region as whether it contains the text or data, whether it is shared or private, and where the data of the region is located in the memory. Clear to everybody? Is this thing is clear to everybody? Okay, now next, so we can move next point. Then comes the process U area. So what is the U area? Now see, U area is there. So U area is the extension of the process table entry, and the fields of the U area are pointer to process table entry of currently executing process, parameters of the current system called return values or the error codes. It contains the file descriptor of all open files. It contains the current directory and the current root, and it contains the input output parameter. It contains the process and the file size limit. So the U area, actually this is the U area. So this U area, what it contains, okay? So now you can say that U area is also one of the very important data structure of the process. Okay, so what it contains, this U area that is shown in the green color, that actually contains the pointer to process table entry. So yeah, the pointer aapko dikhai de raha hai, the pointer to the process table entry. Okay, and for currently executing process, U area contains the pointer to process table entry of currently executing process. Then parameter of the current system call, whatever the current system calls are under execution, so that parameters will be there, including the return values and the error codes. It contains the file descriptor of all open files. The user might open the files, so that it contains the file descriptor of all open files. It contains the current directory and the current root directory, input output parameter, and the process and the file size limit. So these six parameters are there that are the contents of this U area table. Got it? Now below you can read the line, kernel can directly access the field of the U area of the executing process, but not the U area of the other process. But that is a very important point. Kernel can directly access the fields of the U area of the executing process. Okay, P1 is under executing, so uska jo fields hai, U area fields, that can be directly accessible to the kernel, but not the U area of the other process. So whatever the process which is currently active, which is currently in executing, related to that, whatever the U area fields, that can be directly accessible to the kernel, but not the U area of other process. Jo active nahi hai, okay? So active ka matlab kya lenge aap yahan pe? Active ka matlab lenge aap those who are actually under execution by the CPU. सीपीयू जिसका एग्जीक्यूशन कर रहा है दे आर एक्टिव, दे आर इन एग्जीक्यूशन. सो कर्नल कैन डायरेक्टली एक्सेस द फील्ड ऑफ द यू एरिया ऑफ द एग्जीक्यूटिंग प्रोसेस बट नॉट द यू एरिया ऑफ द अदर प्रोसेस. ओके सो दैट इज देयर. This much is there related to this process control subsystem. Process control subsystem के बारे में. और this is actually the part of data structure for the process. Okay? Region table. That means so we learn about region table. So there are entries. We describe the attributes of the region. The where it contain. Whether it contains the text or data. Whether it is shared or private. And where the data of the region is located in the memory. So that means this region table. Okay. So this is all about the data structure of the process control subsystem. Okay. Any difficulty up till this point? Okay. If you are facing any problem, you can ask me. If you want any clarification, you can ask. It is actually very interesting and it requires a continuous follow-up. No? Follow-up means you also require to see all these things after completion, before starting the lecture, after completing the lecture. You also see this because this is very interesting and self-explanatory. Okay, and so even you can see the U area is there and what is the U area. It contains the various six fields are there. Then the process table is there. Process table contains all active processes. Then the process table entries points towards per process region table. There are three regions: the text region, data region, stack region. And that regions will describe the attributes like whether it is a text or data, whether it is a private or shared, and one more is there where the data is located in the memory. Okay, and then the U area. Okay, so this is the data structure of the kernel. Of the data structure of the process. Now what I will do, I will stop here because don't leave the meeting right now. Still we are having 10 minutes. Okay. What I will do, I will not start the next point right now. In this 10 minutes, I will explain the second assignment, that is theoretical assignment. The practical assignments are there. No? So write a function to describe. Okay, so what I will do, I will share the terminal window with you. Be there. So terminal window is visible to everybody now. Okay. So before terminal window, I must share the editor with you, so I will share the editor. Okay. I want to show you the program. Okay. Okay. So now the text editor is there on your screen. Now I will start writing that assignment number 2 or C. We'll start writing directly. First is the PCI devices. So title, so now title, all batches clear with the title, so I will not repeat what is the title of this assignment. I will directly start the USB devices. Okay. Then there is a third one is the third one is the CPU info. Okay. Then we are having the fourth one is the disk info, hard disk info. So you can write here HDD, hard disk info, hard disk information. Info stands for information. And then the fifth one, we are having this mount. Okay, this mount. And the sixth one, we are having this unmount. Okay. And again, one more I can take here, display. Display. Okay. And then the eighth one I am having exit. Okay. So here I can like enter your choice. Okay. So read the choice. And I can use the case statement here. Case dollar ch. Okay, dollar ch in. And then case number one. I can write here case number one in short like ls pci hyphen v, and I can break that case. So second case is what ls usb. Okay, and directly I can break. So third case is what, that is ls cpu, and I can break. The fourth case is df. Fifth one is actually the mount, so we need to call a function here. Function 11 was called function. And sixth one is actually again same function I will call. Okay. And then the seventh one, I want to display something. Yeah? I want to display. So what I want to display, I want to display the mount point. I want to display the mount point so that I will write afterwards. Okay, I will break that case here. And the 8th one is the exit. Okay, and now I can break the case. Okay, this thing is there. So now I want to write the function, function 11. So in the practical batches, some of the students face some problem to execute the function. So my dear student, aapko function kaha pe likhna hai? You need to write the function before calling it. तो आपको ये ऊपर फंक्शन लिखना पड़ेगा. यू नीड टू राइट अ फंक्शन बिफोर दिस मेनू. तो फंक्शन 11, ओके, दिस. एंड इफ आई राइट लाइक दिस, इफ स्टेटमेंट डॉलर ph, ओके, इज इक्वल टू 5 ना. सो माउंट इज 5. सो देन ओके, Then what? Then I want to mount. Then I want to mount. What I want to mount? I want to mount the slash dev slash sdb1. ये पहले हमने some of the batches, some of the student, तो वो उनका program run नहीं हुआ था. क्यों नहीं रहा? Because हमने ये function कहाँ पे लिखा था? बाद में लिखा था. हमने call करने के बाद function लिखा था, तो error आ रहा था. आपको क्या करना है कि initially at the starting you need to डिफाइन द फंक्शन. ओके, तो जैसे मैंने आप यहाँ पे किया है और मैंने माउंट पॉइंट दिया है mnt. ओके, तो एल्स इफ भी लिखना पड़ेगा. एल्स इफ, तो एल्स इफ एल्स इफ डॉलर सी एच देन स्टेटमेंट. Then I want to U mount MNT. Okay, now it is working fine. So, and how I can end these things with file. Okay, this thing is there, and I can close my function. So I hope now this will work. Okay, I have saved the program. सबको दिखाई दे रहा है ना? All okay. So now this program is completed. तो मैं यहाँ पे do while भी देख रखता हूँ. While true, done. Okay. Now we will run the program. Okay. First of all, I will run and then I will share the terminal window. So, share. node sh that is there. So I need super user login, sudo sh prog2.sh. I'm asking for the password. So यहाँ पे मुझे क्या करना है, cat. I want to display the content of MNT. So cat slash MNT. Okay, so just a minute Akshay, yes. Screen is visible, no? Screen is visible to you. Just a minute. Some problem at my laptop because it is not displaying the manual for all this LS PCI LS USB. Okay, so that is the actual program. See, difference is that you need to first of all write a function. आपको क्या करना है कि आपको पहले function लिखना है. This function I have written here. And then you can use the function here in your program, function 11 and function 11. Okay, then it will give the accurate result. So okay, no problem. What happened? We will stop here. Okay, already our time is finished. Okay, so we will stop, and in the practical we will see all these things. So what I will do, I will now end the meeting. Okay, thank you very much for joining.